And now we will learn all about bank reconciliation. Bank reconciliation is a process that ensures that each transaction on the bank statement is exactly the same in our own general ledger. If we are comparing our records to the bank's records, we have to know where these records are. If we were an individual person, not a business, we would have an old-fashioned checkbook register, and every time we wrote a check or made a deposit, we would record it in that check register. However, because we are a business using QuickBooks, our bank records of our bank account transactions are recorded in the general ledger account called Cash in Bank. The bank's records of those very same transactions in our bank account are recorded and sent to us every month on a statement called the bank statement. As we compare our transactions to the transactions recorded on the bank statement, we might notice that something doesn't match. Well, some things are supposed to be different. We account for those different things with our normal bank rec procedures that you will learn in the following videos. If something unexpected is different, that means we found a mistake and we follow the procedures for fixing mistakes. So, what do we expect will not match between our cash account in the general ledger and the bank statement? Well, we should know that the ending balance of the statement will never match the ending balance of our cash records. That's because of the things that we expect that will not match. So, for example, let's imagine that the bank statement balance on the statement cutoff date is $12,000. And let's also imagine on that same date, the last day of the bank statement, our general ledger cash in bank has a balance of $10,000. That's because there are always things that are listed on the bank statement that we did not have the opportunity to record in our general ledger until after we received the statement. And the same thing is true on the other side. There will always be things in our cash in bank, in our QuickBooks records, that the bank will not have an opportunity to record until after they send out the statement. So then your next question should be, what's on the statement that's missing from our cash records? Well, the bank balance already includes a monthly bank fee that we did not have an opportunity to record in our records. The monthly bank fee is reoccurring, and therefore the bank will not send us any kind of notification on the day that they take money out of our bank account. Therefore, we could not possibly know about this fee until after we receive the bank statement in the mail. That's why the bank statement balance includes the fee, but our records do not. The bank statement balance also includes interest that the bank will give us and add to our account. This happens automatically, and the bank does not give us any special notification that they put interest into our account. They simply add the interest and expect us to find out about this after we receive the statement in the mail. So these two items were impossible for us to record before we get the bank statement, and therefore they were included in the bank balance, but not ours. If our records are completely correct except for these two items, that means when we include these items, we should get the correct balance of cash as of the statement cutoff date, the last day of the statement. To be fair, you should also ask, what's in our cash records that's not on the statement? Our cash records in our QuickBooks already includes things that the bank did not have an opportunity to record and put on the statement. For example, outstanding checks are checks that we already subtracted from our balance. These are checks that we wrote close to or on the cutoff date of the bank statement that we included in our balance that the bank did not have an opportunity to record in their balance until after they printed the statement and mailed it out. We will imagine in this example the total outstanding checks, the total of the checks that fit that description is $4,200. We also have included in our balance deposits under the same idea. Deposits in transit are deposits that we recorded in our QuickBooks records close to or on the cutoff date of the bank statement. These are deposits that the bank did not have an opportunity to record in their records until after they printed and mailed the statement. So, if the bank did not make any mistake to their balance, all they would have to do is include these two things, the two things that they did not know about, and the bank should then have the correct balance. And both numbers should match. This is an example of a bank reconciliation report, the way it would look in the days before the computer. Notice we start with our balance and include only the things that the bank knew about that we did not in order to get the correct balance. If we take the bank balance and include the things that they did not, then their balance should be the same as ours, because this balance assumes that both of us know about every transaction before the cutoff date of the statement. So how do we actually do bank reconciliation? Well, as soon as we get the monthly statement, the first thing we do is record into our records the interest and service charge. This way, we're halfway finished. If we take the two things that we didn't know about and then we record them into our records, our cash and bank records immediately become the corrected balance. The next step in the process is to add the deposits in transit and subtract the outstanding checks to and from the bank's balance. After we do that, we see if it's the same number that we got when we corrected our records. So, we will take these two items that only the bank, that only we knew about, and we will add and subtract them to the bank's balance as of the cutoff date. If we factor them into the bank's balance, we should come up with the same exact number that we came up with when we put in things that only the bank knew about. Now that both of us know about everything, we should have the same ending balance as of the cutoff date of the bank statement. Now that first step was easy. To find the interest and service charge, just look on the bank statement. But the second step requires answering this question. How do we find the outstanding checks and the deposits in transit? Well, we hold up the bank statement right next to a printout of all of our records and cash in bank. We compare each transaction one by one to make sure that everything matches. And we follow a simple common sense rule. Anything that is in our records in the QuickBooks cash in bank account that is not on the bank statement must be a deposit in transit or an outstanding check. We take the total of those items and we put them back on the bank reconciliation report that you saw a minute ago. A mistake is any transaction that is not the same in both places. To find out who made the mistake, go back to the source document of that transaction. For example, if we have a check recorded differently than what is on the bank statement, we have to go back to the original copy of that check to see who is right and who is wrong. Same thing for a deposit. If the bank recorded a deposit differently than we have in our QuickBooks records, we have to go back to the initial deposit slip and see who is right and who is wrong. We follow very simple common sense procedures if we find a mistake. If it's our mistake, we close the bank rec window that we were using for this process. Then we fix our QuickBooks records the same way we learned how to fix mistakes in previous videos. After we do that, we reopen the reconciliation window and continue the process. However, if it's the bank's mistake, the first thing you need to do is call the bank. Upon calling or notifying the bank, you have to show or send a copy of the check or deposit slip that proves the bank made a mistake on a specific transaction. After that, you should request a copy of the corrected statement. After you get a copy of the corrected statement, you should again continue the bank reconciliation process.